Alright, my dear students, this is ARD. Today we are going to discuss about reducing balance depreciation. Now, before going through this video lecture, I may suggest you that you must watch the straight line method first, because in this question, it is actually basically a continuity of a previous question that we started with the name of ARD Textiles. It was not a past paper exam question, but was a question created by me just as to make sure that you may easily understand the concepts underlying depreciation. First of all, you should watch straight line method for this question, ARD Textiles. Then if you have already watched straight line method, now let's move to reducing balance method. Now the first requirement remains the same, that is, we need to make a machine account. A machine account is the same whether it is made using straight line method or whether it is created using reducing balance method. Now the ARD Textiles has started its business in 2013. The question is given in the previous video, and the question link is also available in the video description of this video. Now, there was no machines previously, as it was the first year we just started the business, so there was no balance brought down. If there would have been any balance brought down, this should come on the debit side, because the machine is a non-current asset and non-current asset is always debited. We first bought a machine in 2013 on 1st February for 100,000. The entry that would be making is machine account debited and bank account would be credited. If the question does not mention that we have bought the machine through check or through credit, we will always write through check, that is bank. But if the question mentions the name of the supplier, then we assume that we have bought the stock or anything, we have bought an asset on credit terms. Now in 2013, there was no other machine bought other than this 100,000 machine. So therefore, we need to balance this account for 2013. As you may be aware, the lower side is always balance carried down. So in this question, the lower side is credit side. So if there are only one item on either side, in each side, we do not need to write the total again. We just need to rule off this. What I mean by rule off, we just need to put double line underline that. Then after that, in 2013, if the year ends in 2013, the next year starts on January 2014. If we had 100,000 machine at the end of the year, this same 100,000 machine would be owned by us at the start of the next year. Then in 2014, we bought two machines cost 35,000 each from Honda Limited, which was bought on 1st August 2014. August is a month of independence for Pakistan. Then we bought a machine for 70,000, two machines. Previously, we had one machine for 100,000. Then we bought two machines for 70,000. Now the total becomes 170,000. If we're saying that we have bought the machine from Honda Limited, means we have bought the machine on credit terms, the entry would be machine account debit and Honda would be credited. Then the lower side, the lesser side would be balance CD. The balance CD or the totals always comes in front of each other. See, these 100,000 are also facing each other. Then this 170,000 also same. Then this balance carried down, closing balance at end of the 2014 would become opening balance at the start of the next year, that is 2015. Now you may see in the question, there are no transactions for 2015. This means the machine that we had at start of the 2015 would be the same machine that would be had at end of 2015. So the balance brought down becomes balance carried down. All the assets and liability accounts need to be balanced, and the lower side becomes balance carried down, and this becomes balance brought down on the next side. Then the last year is there, 2016. In 2016, we have not bought any machine, but what we have done, we have sold the existing machine. Which machine we have sold, as you may read in the question, on 1st September 2016, that machine that we bought in 2013 was sold for 40,000. Although we have sold the machine for 40,000, but the account that we are right now making is a cost account. If the question does not mentions which account we need to make. If the question just says you need to make a machine account, this means we have to make a machine cost account. So the machine that we sold for 40,000 actually cost the business 100,000. So whenever we are buying the machine account is debited because the asset increases on the debit side. And whenever we are selling the machine, we would be crediting the machine. And what we'll be doing, we'll be crediting it and we'll be transferring it to disposal account. Now, if you have already done with the previous lecture, the ARD textile straight line method, you may be aware that the disposal account is basically a temporary account used to calculate or to record gain or loss on disposal. It is just a temporary account. So whatever we will be doing, whenever we are selling some non-current asset, we'll be crediting the asset account and we'll be debiting the disposal account. We are actually transferring the cost of the asset that we just sold to the disposal account. And the original cost of that asset that we sold for 40,000 was 100,000. So we'll be writing 100,000 and not the 40,000. The 40,000 that the amount that we received on the disposal of the asset will be rather used in a disposal account. We'll be making it in the later part of the video. Then the shorter side would be against balance CD. Again, balance CD would be shorter side. Again, both sides are equal. We had machines worth 170,000 at the start of the year. And in this year, we sold the machine that originally cost us 100,000. So if we deduct 100,000 from 170, we'll be getting only the 70,000 that these are the Honda machines that remains with us. And maybe the Toyota machine we already sold. So this balance CD becomes balance BD the next accounting period. And the question is that, sir, till how many years we need to carry down or brought down the balance BD? We just need to brought down to the next accounting period, that is the next date. If you can see the question, the requirement is to make the machine account and the provision account for the years 2013, 14, 15 and 16. The last year or the last requirement is to make the account for 2016. So what we need to do, we need to balance brought down for the next accounting period or the next day is 1st January 2017. So I hope you understood the underlying concept behind making the machine account, which is something a revision for you. We have already done that. Now the next part is depreciation calculation. Why we need to calculate depreciation first? Because the question specifically asks us to make a provision for depreciation account in the second requirement. Provision for depreciation account is also known as accumulated depreciation account. Provision for depreciation, accumulated depreciation means it is a total depreciation till date of the machines. So prior to making, before making that provision account, we need to calculate depreciation so that we can put it into our provision account. So the first year of the business is 2013. In 2013, we bought one machine for cost for 100,000. This is basically the rough working. This is not required in the examination, but you may be able to calculate this in order to get the values that will be putting it in the account. Then we have first year is 2013. If you can see the question states that now we have to resolve the question using reducing balance. Now what I am doing, I am solving the question again using reducing balance, and the rate for reducing balance depreciation is 20%. So what we need to do, we need to calculate depreciation for the first year. We'll be calculating on the original cost. So 100,000 times 20% becomes 20,000. Now in the first year, the machine that we bought for 100,000 is depreciated by 20,000. Now what we need to do, we need to calculate the net book value of the machine on the go. What does net book value means? Net book value means the value that remains in the books after the depreciation has been charged, or the remaining value after depreciation that remain in the books is net book value. So if I deduct 20,000 from the 100,000 value, I will be getting the value remaining, that is 80,000. So we may move to the next year. See, if in next year, if I have not bought any machine or sold any machine, I'll be calculating depreciation on the remaining 80,000 and not the 100,000. Now this is the basic or important difference between a straight line method and a reducing balance method. In a straight line method, if the rate is 20%, I need to calculate 20% on 100,000 each year. That is, all of the years that I'm using the machine, the depreciation charge would remain the same, that is 20,000. in each year I'll be calculating 20% on the original cost, that is 100,000. But in the reducing balance method, the depreciation is reduced, depreciation is deducted each year in order to calculate net book value, and now the 20% would be applied on the remaining 80,000, that is net book value. Now in the second year, that is 2014, I have also bought some new machines, and the new machines are bought from Honda Limited for 70,000. So the previous value or the remaining value of the 100,000 machine was 80,000, and I bought new machine for 70,000, although there are two machines for 70, one was for 35 and two are for 70. Now if I add both of these, I'll be getting the net book value of 150. Now what I need to do, I need to calculate a 20% on the remaining value 80,000 and also the new machine that I bought for 70,000. So rather than multiplying 20% to 80,000 first and then to 70,000, what I am doing, I am multiplying it all together. So I am depreciating 150,000 asset for 20% for the next accounting period, that is 2014. So 150 times 20% becomes 30,000. So 150 minus 30,000, the remaining net book value is only 120,000. Now you may see the question, in 2015 I have not either bought any new machine nor I have sold any machine, so I need to depreciate a 20,000 further. Now the 20,000 will be applied on the remaining net book value of 120 and not the previous net book value, that is 150. Now I'll be multiplying 120,000 with 20% in order to get further depreciation of 24,000 for the next year, that is 2015. Now at the end of 2015 or at the start of 2016, the net book value becomes 96,000. So although this is the last year, technically or ideally I should have depreciated 20% of this amount, that is 96,000, but there comes a problem, a real problem arises in 2016. And what is basically that problem? The problem is that I have sold one of the machine. See, my dear students, if we have sold the machine that we have sold would not be depreciated, because in this question we are using a full year policy. A full year policy means we will be charging a full year depreciation in the year of purchase and will be charging no depreciation in the year of disposal. In a monthly depreciation, or also which is known as time proportion method, will be depreciating the asset in the year of purchase as well as in the year of disposal, because in the monthly depreciation we may calculate the months, the actual number of months the asset is actually being used. If we have bought the machine and used it for 3 months only, we'll be charging 3 months depreciation, and we have sold the machine or maybe on the 30th June, we'll be charging only 6 months depreciation in the year of disposal. But this is not the case in this question. In this question, we are using a full year policy, and in the full year policy, we'll be not charging depreciation on the asset disposed of. Now, I may need to ask you a question, although I can't answer, I can't hear to your replies, but I just need to ask you the question here. Do this 96,000 includes all of the machines? Yes, this 96,000 includes the 100,000 machine as well as the 70,000 Honda machines. It includes both of the machines. Now what I need to do, I need to deduct the value of the machine that I have just sold. Now the problem arises, the machine that I have actually basically sold originally cost me 100,000. So can I deduct 100,000 from this 96,000 value? No. If I deduct 100,000 from this 96,000 value, the remaining value would be negative. So this cannot be the case. So what I need to do, the problem is that, my dear students, this 96,000 is basically the net book value, and the 100,000 is basically the cost of the asset. So what I need to do, I need to calculate the net book value of the 100,000 machine. Net book value means the remaining value of the asset after 3 years of its use. So how we need to calculate the net book value? We need to calculate it in a separate working, and I'm showing this working to you first. See, my dear students, the machine that I bought in 2013 originally cost me 100,000. First of all, I depreciated it 20% in the first year, that is 2013. I depreciated it for 20,000. So if I deduct 20,000 from the 100,000 value, I may get the value, net book value for 80,000. Now in the second year was 2014, I need to depreciate 20,000, 20% further. Now the 20% would be charged on the original cost 100,000 or the remaining value 80,000. Yes, on the remaining value 80,000, because it is a reducing balance method. Now at the end of 2 years, the net book value becomes 64,000. Now if in the third year, that is 2015, I may depreciate 20% further. Now the 20% would be charged on the 80,000 value, or it would be charged on 64,000. Yes, it would be charged on 64,000. This value becomes 12,800. Further depreciation would be charged in order to get the net book value after 3 years, that is 51,200. So this 51,200 is basically the net book value of the machine that we sold in 2016. We have used it for 3 consecutive years, that is 2013, that is 2014 and 15. So after 3 years of depreciation, the net book value that remains in our books is 51,200. Now there is an easier and shortcut method of calculating this 51,200. I may share this with you as well. So what we need to do, we need to see that what is the depreciation rate in this question. The rate of depreciation is basically 20%. Now if I deduct 20% out of the 100%, I will be getting the value, that is 80%. So if I depreciate $20 of the asset out of the $100 value, I will be getting the remaining $80 value at the end of the year. So at each year, the asset remains 80% of the original value, of the previous value. So what I need to do, I need to calculate, I bought the machine for 100,000. In the first year, the value remained 80%. So 1 lakh multiplied by 80% or 0.8, then the value that comes, it comes 80,000. You may use the calculator for this. Then out of the 80%, we just need to multiply by 80% again in order to get the value 64,000. Then the 64,000 should be multiplied by 0.8 or 80% again in order to get the net book value, that is 51,000. So I may repeat this point. We just need to multiply 100,000, that is original cost, with 80% 3 times. 100,000 times 0.8 times 0.8 times 0.8. Why we are multiplying 0.8 or 80% 3 times, first of all for 2013, then for 2014, and then the last for 2015. If you are good at maths, you just need to do this. 100,000 multiplied by 0.8 power 3. So power 3 means we need to depreciate it for 3 times, 100,000.8, in order to get this value 51,200. Now what is this 51,200? This is the remaining value of the asset that we sold in 2016. So out of the 96,000 net book value, we'll be deducting 51,200 net book value in order to get the remaining net book value, that is 44,800. So now what is this value 44,800? This is the net book value of the asset that remained in the books, or this is the asset that we are just using. As you may remember, this is the Honda machine that we bought for 70,000. We can also check this value. We just need to multiply 70,000 multiply by 0.8, we'll be getting 56,000. Then we'll be multiplying 56,000 multiply by 0.8 again in order to get this value. Means the Honda machine that cost us 70,000, after 2 years of use of 2014 and 15, the remaining value is this. Now what we need to do, we just need to depreciate the Honda machine for the last year, that is 2016, and we need to multiply it with a 20%. 44,800 multiplied by 20%, so the depreciation is only 8,960. So can you tell me why is the depreciation so low for the last year 2016? Yes, because we have sold one of the machines that we have bought for 100,000, and now the only machine that remains with us is the Honda machine, that is 70,000. So these are the four important values that we need to calculate. One for 20, then 30, then 24,000, then 8,960. So if you remember the straight line method for this question, in this the same question, straight line method, the answers were 15,000 in the first year and then 170 multiplied by 15% was 25,500. Then it was 25,500 again, and the last year it was 10,500 because we are calculating the depreciation on the original cost. Now, if you understood this depreciation, now the other things that are very easy, we just need to make a provision for depreciation account. Provision for depreciation account is basically the same whether we are using the straight line or we are using reducing balance. Everything is basically the same. Only the depreciation calculation differs in terms of its calculation. Other than that, everything is the same. So I may repeat it for you. This provision account, provision is basically a contra asset. What does a contra asset mean? Contra asset means something that reduces the value of a non-current asset. As you may be aware, a machine is a non-current asset. The nature of it is debit. If we are reducing the value of the machine, the provision for depreciation becomes credit because nature of it is credit. So we need to first revise or recall the general entries for depreciation. As you may be aware, that depreciation is an expense. So whenever there's an expense, income statement would be debited, and rather than creating the machine account directly, we just need to make a separate account with the name of provision for depreciation, also known as accumulated depreciation. Provision for depreciation is also known as accumulated depreciation. As we may be aware, this is the first year of the business for ARD Textile. We have just started the business in 2013. So there is no balance brought down previously. So if there is no balance brought down, if there would have been any balance brought down, it should have come on the credit side. Because there is no balance brought down, the first year, that is 2013, we have charged depreciation for 20,000. The entry that we need to make is income statement debit, and provision account would be credited. Now, is this the account for income statement or provision? It is the account for provision, because the provision account would be credited with the reference, that is income statement. So the shorter side is the debit side. We just need to make balance both of the sides. So the shorter side comes balance carried down. The first year ends and 31st December 2013. So if there is only one item on each other side, we just need to rule off this, and we do not need to write totals 20,000 again. So this balance carried down, that is closing balance, becomes balance brought down in the next accounting period, that is January 14. So in the next year, we just need to chart the depreciation again. The next year depreciation we just calculated in the previous slide, there was 30,000. So entry would be income statement account would be debited because it is an expense, and provision account need to be increased, that is 30,000. So if I add both of these 2 years depreciation, the total depreciation becomes 50,000. Now again, the shorter side becomes balance carried down. Although you need to be aware, these totals should come in front of each other in order to present something good. So the balance carried down becomes balance brought down in the next accounting period, that is 50,000. Now in the third year, we just need to calculate depreciation again, and the third year depreciation was 24,000. Now what I'm doing, I'm basically adding up the depreciation for all of the years in order to calculate provision for depreciation or accumulated depreciation till date. So this becomes 74,000. Again, the shorter side is debit side. The debit side becomes balance carried down, and this balance carried down becomes balance brought down in the last accounting year, that is 2016. So in 2016, we just need to calculate depreciation again. We have just calculated depreciation, and it was much lower than the previous years because we have just left up with two of the Honda machines, a smaller machines, and the bigger one machine, the 100,000 one, we already sold it. So what we need to do, so ideally what we should have done, this 82,960 should have become the balance CD and it becomes the balance BD. But here something we just need to know is that whenever we are selling some machine, we are transferring that machine into disposal account. If the machine no longer belongs to us, the total depreciation of that machine is also of no use to us. So what we need to do, we need to transfer the total depreciation till date of the machine that we have just sold into a separate account known as disposal account. So if you may be aware that we have made the machine account previously, in the machine account, that when we sold the machine, we transferred that machine into disposal, because the nature of the machine account account was debit. Whenever we are buying the machine, we are debiting it, and when we are selling the machine, we are crediting it and transfer into disposal account. Now, having said that, we need to apply the same setup in this and the same methodology in this. What I need to do, if I sold some machine, I may need to transfer the total depreciation of the machine that you have just sold into a separate account known as disposal account. So the provision for depreciation is basically a contra asset. It increases by way of credit, and if I need to decrease that provision for depreciation account, what I need to do, I need to debit that provision account and I need to transfer it into a separate account known as disposal. So what would be the value that I may be putting it at? The value would be the total depreciation till date. See, I have done the calculation for this. The machine that we have just sold was depreciated in the first year for 20,000, in the second year for 16, and in the third year for 12,800. Now, if I add all of these three negative values, I may get the total depreciation, that is 48,800. Now, maybe one of you watching this video may have a question in the mind that what if, sir, I have used the shortcut method you have just illustrated here and I have not made this whole working. So what I need to do, I need to multiply 100,000 into 0.8 three times. I am getting the final value, net book value is 51,200. So I do not have these three values, that is 20, 16 and 12,800 respectively. So there's no problem altogether for this. What we need to do, we need to minus or deduct the 51,200 from the original cost, that is 100,000. I may explain this to you. The machine that I bought for 100,000 remains, the value that remains after 3 years of use is 51,200. If I deduct 51,200 remaining value from the original cost, I may easily get this value, that is disposal net book value. So this is the total provision for depreciation. Sorry, this is not the net book value. This is the provision for depreciation of the asset that I've just sold. This is a total depreciation or accumulated depreciation till date. So lastly, I need to do the same procedure. 82,960 is the total depreciation. I need to deduct 48,800 in order to get the balance CD value, that is closing balance. So the balance CD value is now 34,160. This balance carried down value becomes balance brought down. The question then arises, till when we need to make a balance BD? We just need to make the balance BD for the next day. Next day is 1st January or next accounting period, that is 1st January 2017. Now the next requirement in this question is making a disposal account. The purpose of the disposal account is to record gain or loss on disposal. Now first we need to record or first we need to calculate the gain or loss. We just need to calculate gain and loss first in order to make a disposal account to record the entries. Now the machine that we have sold originally cost us 100,000, then after 3 years of use we depreciated it for 48,800. Now the remaining value in our books is 51,200. Now we need to do, what we need to do, we need to deduct the proceeds. Proceeds is basically the amount that we received on the disposal of the asset. Now the asset that was lying in a box with a value of 51,200 was sold for 40,000. Now the value that we sold it for is less than the value that remain in the books. So the difference would be loss on disposal, that is 11,200. This is the loss on disposal. Or if we would have sold the asset for maybe 60,000, because of 60,000 is the greater than the value that remain in the books, the difference would be the gain on disposal. So if we are selling for less than the net book value, the difference is loss for loss on disposal. And if we are selling for more than its net book value, the difference would be gain on disposal. So if the question asks for you, specifically asks you to calculate gain or loss, so this is the working that we need to show. But in this question, I'm not just interested in calculating gain or loss, I want you to make a disposal account. So although I can make a disposal account directly as well, I may teach you the disposal entries first, because sometimes in the examination question entries are being tested, and sometime in the examination question disposal account is being tested. So what I am doing, I am making both of these things for you, so you may prepare yourself for any scenario that comes in the examination question. So there are basically four entries relating to disposal. First entry is the original cost. Original cost is the actual amount that we paid for when we bought the asset originally, historically. Then secondly, the second entry would be the total depreciation till date, also known as accumulated depreciation, that is 48,800 in this case. Thirdly, we need to make an entry of the amount that we used for actually when we sold the asset, that is 40,000. And last but not the least is the gain or loss on disposal. So basically we need to make four entries, one for cost, second for total depreciation till date, third is the bank value, that the amount that we receive on the disposal, and lastly for gain or loss. Now what are we trying to sell here? We need to sell our faith, or we need to sell our respect, or what do we need to sell? We need to sell a machine here. You're exactly right. The machine is basically debit. The machine is an asset. So whenever we are buying a machine, we will be debiting the machine, and whenever we are selling it, we'll be crediting the machine. So machine is credited, and the original cost is 100,000. So in all of these four entries that are coming here, one thing is common, that is disposal account. In all of the entries, one side always comes off disposal account. Now disposal can comes on the debit or credit side. It can comes on either side. It has no specific beliefs. Maybe the disposal account is an atheist. He does not believe on anything. So disposal account can comes on either side. What we need to remember is that where does the machine account comes? Machine is crediting. We are selling the machine, then the disposal would be debited. Now, if the machine, we have just sold the machine, now the total depreciation that we have is of no use to us. Now, the total depreciation till date was 48,400. What we need to do, we need to debit the provision account. Why are we debiting the provision account? Provision account is also known as accumulated depreciation, because we are decreasing it. We are reversing the provision account. If we are debiting provision account, the credit entry would be made in a separate account known as disposal account. Now again, disposal account can comes on either side, debit or credit. Thirdly, if we have sold the machine for 40,000, we'll be basically receiving money through check or cash. If nothing is mentioned, we'll be writing bank. Maybe we have sold the machine on credit to one of our relatives or friend, so the name of the relative or friend would comes on the debit side. If I don't know the name, I'll be writing debtor. If I know the name Mr. Ali, I'll be debiting Mr. Ali and crediting with the remaining value, that is disposal account. Now if you may see, in all of the entries, one side is always disposal. And last but not the least would be the gain or loss entry. In this question, we have loss on disposal. The nature of the loss is debit. Why? Because the loss decreases our capital. So the entry would be income statement would be debited with the loss. If the income statement is debited, the disposal account would be credited. Income statement debit and disposal account would be credited. In this question, if there would have been a gain in the question, the entry would have been reversed. Income statement that is currently debited would be credited, because the gain, nature of the gain is credit, and the disposal account that is credited would be debited because it was a gain. And now in the third requirement, we need to make a disposal account, which was basically required. Now if you may see the entries, in first of the entry we are debiting disposal account. So what I would need to do, I would be debiting disposal account, and what is being credited, being credited is a machine is being credited. So I'll be writing the reference of machine. Now in the second entry, what I'm doing, I am crediting disposal account. So disposal account would be credited for 48,800, and will be debiting provision for depreciation, also known as accumulated depreciation. Now in the third entry, as you may be aware, disposal account is crediting again. Will be using reference of bank, or if we would have sold on credit, The reference would be name of the customer, that is Mr. Ali. And last, we have income statement entry, disposal account is being credited again, and the reference would be income statement. We also need to mention gain or loss which carry 1 mark. So this writing this gain or loss is necessary in the examination question. Now if you may see, there is no balance carried down in a disposal account. Disposal account is basically a temporary account that does not contain any balance brought down or balance carried down. Any of the remaining balance or the balance that remain in disposal account is being transferred to income statement as a gain or loss. So this now you may also see the dates. All of the dates would be the date that we on the date that we sold the machine, that is 1st September, but in the income statement we'll be writing the date, that is end of the year. So the year in which the asset is disposed of was 2016, so we'll be writing year end date in income statement, and all of the other entries will be writing 1st September. And last but not the least, we have income statement and balance sheet extract requirement. So extract means we are not making full-fledged income statement. We just need to make the part of the income statement that contains entries relating to depreciation. So as you may be aware, depreciation is an expense. So expense, or maybe it is a something that is income, always comes in income statement. Now if you recall the format for income statement, if you have studied one, is sales less cost of sales comes gross profit, then we add other income, then we deduct expenses in order to get net profit, also known as profit for the year. So the expenses or other income both comes after gross profit. So we'll be starting our extract with gross profit. Now, although gross profit is not given in such type of questions, so I'm just writing an X because this figure is unknown. Now in gross profit we'll be adding other income. In other income we'll be mentioning gain on disposal, but in this question there is no gain on disposal. I've just written it so that you may be aware that if there would have been a gain, would come in this side, other income. Then we have expenses, that is disposal, we have depreciation expense, and one is loss on disposal. Now when we started this question, we calculated depreciation and we are using a reducing balance. In reducing balance, we calculated depreciation for all of the 4 years. First year depreciation was 20,000, it is an expense. Second year depreciation increased to 30 because we have bought another machines. Third year it reduced to 24,000 because the machines are getting older, net book value is decreasing, and the last value depreciation dropped because we have sold one of the machine. Then there was a loss on disposal, that the year in which that we asset sold was 2016. So there was a loss in 2016. So this is basically the income statement extract. The format is basically the same, whether you use straight line or reducing, only the values come changed. Then we have lastly statement of financial position extract. If you have made the balance sheet or statement of financial position earlier, you may be aware that balance sheet start with assets or non-current assets. So we'll be making a vertical format instead of the horizontal one, because we need to make a 4 year balance sheet extract. First of all, we'll be starting with the cost. There are three columns, basically cost, accumulated depreciation and net book value. Now the machine cost, then we'll be deducting accumulated depreciation in order to get the final value, that is net book value. So see, in the first year I had only one machine, that is 100,000. In the second year I have bought another machine for 70,000. The total value becomes 170,000. In the third year I have another machine, no, in the third year 2015 there is no increase or decrease in the machine, then again 170 would be coming, and in the last year 100,000 machine is sold and the only value that remains, that is 70,000. Then in the accumulated depreciation part, you may see in the first year the depreciation was 20. The accumulated depreciation is the total depreciation, it also becomes 20,000. In the second year we have basically 2 years depreciation. As you may be aware, accumulated depreciation means total depreciation. As you may see here, in the first year depreciation was 20, in the second year it was 30. If I add both of these two values, I may get the total value, that is 50,000. Now in the third year I've already reached to the 50,000. What I need to do, I need to add all 3 years of depreciation. So the total depreciation for all 3 years becomes 74,000. And in the last, what I need to do, I need to add all of these 4 years depreciation. And then I also need to deduct a value, that is the machine that we have sold. If the machine we have, if we have sold one of the machine, we do not need the depreciation of that particular machine. So I may need to deduct that 48,800 in order to get this 34160. So I've already made a provision for depreciation account. These values are basically the balance carried down. Balance carried down. You may see here in this question, in the first year balance carried down was 20, then it was 50, then it was 74, and the last year it was 34160. So in the balance sheet, this is the all values that are coming. These are balance carried down. Balance carried down are closing value. Now if I deduct 20,000 from the original cost, I may get the net book value. Now the 170,000 machines have been depreciated for 50. The remaining value is 120. Then again 170 minus 74, the value is 96. And in the last year is 34840. So I hope, student, you are able to understand the concepts behind reducing balance depreciation. So if you haven't subscribed the channel now, this is the last time and this is the last warning I'm giving to you. Unless and until if you don't subscribe to my channel, I may kick out of you. Sorry. Thank you, Ji.